Hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. Hope you're all well. Squiggly squiggly. And yes, we're going to be doing a video all about, I don't know why I'm freaking doing this, but this is going to be a video all about the improvements, the buffs to Old Man Logan, as well as Colossus. The last 48 hours information about what is proposed as the beta buffs for Old Man Logan as well as Colossus have been seen online. Full information links can be found in the description down below, as well as the video that's been put out by Marvel Contest Champions Trucos. What we're going to do is compare the changes and also some things to look out for that looks really positive. As you know, for a while it has been the case that Pop the Claws has been the main signature ability. Based on different stars levels, this will differ, but for me, for this, being a signature 40 and a 5 star, it is when Logan pops his claws for a special attack, each attack has a 17% chance to cause an additional bleed for each charge of pacifism he has at the time, inflicting 5, 8, 9 direct damage over 3 seconds. The proposed signature ability, and do bear in mind all this is subject to change, is called Old Scars. Whenever Logan gains one of his 0 damage passive bleeds, it has a 61.70% chance to gain plus 400% duration. Logan's first special attack, each fight gains 2981 attack rating. So that sounds pretty darn insane, and as well with the bleed stuff that we're going to look at in a minute, seems to be very darn important for bleeding out the enemy. As we know, there's not a huge amount in abilities that are really working for this character. Yes, you do have pacifism, yes, you do have the build of cruelty as well as fury, and there are decent synergies out there to improve his regeneration, which, let's face it, is constantly there, but it isn't constantly consistent. And that is something I think Kabam are really looking to improve with his new abilities that we're going to see. So Old Man Logan gets 100% chance to hit off a regeneration buff every 10 seconds. And it's not too bad, it's not too brilliant, and this I think is where the synergy build around him may come into play. But it doesn't stop there. While the regeneration buff is active, incoming bleed effects gain plus 50% duration, but suffer 95% less potency, given Logan more time to deal with them. One thing that's quite impressive is ability accuracy. It cannot be decreased or increased. This is something that's quite important, especially with champions like Archangel that reduce down ability accuracy and others such like it. It is kind of weird, but also kind of cool to see something a little bit different. He sees critical resistance as well as special attack 3 ignoring armor rating as an improvement. So that is pretty unique and good to see. Also, by landing attacks, blocking attacks, and being struck, Logan has a 45% chance to gain a passive bleed lasting 14 seconds, which deals 0 damage and a max 15 stacks. And as we've seen with the signature ability, this really comes into play. Also, for those champions that purify effects, well, this plays in towards Logan's favor. By every time the opponent instantly takes 1573 direct damage for each bleed they purify. So that is good. And also by the same token, heavy attacks. Now with characters that pause effects, like we've got Spider-Man's stealth suit, by doing evade, you keep that fury buff on. The same thing applies in this scenario. So the first hit, it allows to refresh the duration of Logan's 0 damage passive bleed effects. And also with the second hit, 100% chance to pause the duration of all active fury buffs for 2 seconds. Helpful if you want to do a lot more damage. But it looks like it doesn't stop there with a ferocity. And this is something that's incredibly exciting. Tapping into the Wolverine of old, Logan removes all regeneration and bleed effects from himself, gaining 1 fury buff each effect removed this way. These buffs last 12 seconds and grant plus 272.74 attack, max stacks 15. Special attacks are unblockable if Logan has 5 or more fury buffs. That is insane. On paper, I'm already incredibly impressed by what I've seen so far. And obviously do bear in mind that is subject to change, and a lot of the stats are representative of 5 stars at 565. But still, look, the unblockable stuff, the fury stuff, the regeneration improving, these are amazing, especially stacking up things like the fury and it being so much more positive for the character. And just the fact of that, like about 2-3 years ago, I made a mistake in a video when I said Wolverine has fury. Now at least I can say that the ferocity has now been given back to Logan, or the Wolverine type characters in this particular subject. So like, I'm really happy about this if this is the change that they propose to make. Also, something not to write off, the synergies. Old Man Logan is now useful against characters like The Thing as well as Korg. Didn't expect that to be a thing, but man, I'm so happy to see it. Also, not to mention the fact that if you pair up Mysterio, it's going to improve the damage passive bleed ability, and also his regeneration rate is increased by 10%. Happy days. Oh yeah, and his special attacks get this kind of really crazy look into where they're able to put in a shattered armor, which is going to be amazing, especially going up against some really tricky champions. It's not working with champions that are robots, which obviously we're thinking of Medusa here. But still, it's like totally amazing to see the workaround of things with extra bits for bleeding when it comes to fury attacks, as well as just putting armor break in, which I think is kind of cool for this character. I'm very excited for the future. I know a lot of us do actually have to wait until the fall for these characters to actually be put into the game, because at the moment I think this is the start point of these characters being in beta and reviewed before they're actually launched into the game. So don't expect this to be like, oh, they're going to be here next month. No, they're not. They're really not going to be. And now on to Colossus. And well, as you can see, there's not much really going on for this character. We've got all attacks, one attack, passive, special attacks, and finally signature ability. And when you look at the signature ability, one attack and when attacking, Peter's organic metal skin shapes and strengthens to his will and with no limit, increasing armor rating by 414.84 with a fixed 7% chance. Pretty pathetic. And obviously this does vary based on signature and as well, obviously whatever starage level you have. So nothing really going for it. What's going to change? Let's begin with the signature ability, the Mighty Colossus. Colossus has mastered his armor up buffs, allowing him increased opportunities to trigger them. Whenever one of Colossus' immunities protects him from an effect, he has a 0% chance or X% chance to gain an armor up buff lasting 2 seconds. During special attacks, Colossus gains prowess, increasing his special attacks by X amount of damage. Look, these numbers, but it's not really confirmed just yet, but the percentage as well as the chance could go up based on signature ability. Which even looks like the information on Trucos' video is not there as well, so maybe there's a lot of things to kind of understand just yet. Let's have a look at the passives. Colossus is immune to all bleed, yep. Incinerate, what? Cold snap and frostbite effects? Additionally, if he's not fighting a tech champion, he's also immune to armor break debuffs. Okay, that is pretty cool. So like an armor champion is going to be immune to armor break debuffs. Oh man, that is that's some next level shit there. That's pretty cool. And also there's some beneficial effects for the champion. So if he starts with an armor break buff, an armor buff that is, and as well when it comes to X-Men champions, he gains an additional buff for each on the team. So oh man, that sounds amazing. Also, it seems that the champion is actually getting stocked. He's getting stacked. He's going to be able to smash properly. With those armor buffs being on, he's able to increase his critical damage rating, so we're actually going to get the damage output from this guy that he richly deserves. The damn sight better than what we've got at the moment. I like the way that Kabam have done something pretty unique, and this is all around the buff creation. Now, it's easier to get an armor up buff and also sustain it by doing well-timed blocks. The better thing surrounding it is the whole way and functionality around the parry mastery. So if Colossus has the parry mastery, this will do an additional 1,162 direct damage. Similar to, like, if you've seen the Deadpool movie, you'll know that when Deadpool goes to hit Colossus, that he indeed, like, breaks his hand in the process. It's kind of like the same principle, so I like that tiny little nod to that. And especially, it just turns him into the Colossus, not just from the comics, but it now brings it into this kind of reality. Don't hit Colossus, because it's going to be bad. Just maybe intercept instead. Also, something very weird is, I don't know if Kabam are planning to change the animations. By reading this, it looks like they are. As you know from the L1 of Colossus, he does a drop kick. But now it says a titanic gut punch softens them up and a charging overhand haymaker sends them flying. Which kind of either looks like it could be the L2, but I don't know. I think something has changed, especially because this is on the SP2. Colossus demonstrates hand-to-hand combat with enough superhuman strength to careen 100 tons. And then the SP3 says, in flesh form, he's a man, and in steel form, he's a hero. Who dares striking the mighty Colossus? Which kind of like looks like it could be similar to the current SP3. But I don't know. I'll put in the comment section, like, what do you think? Do you think this is going to be changing? Either way, some of the special attacks are really positive to armor up buffs, and obviously sustaining it. Even off the L1, you get an indefinite armor up buff, so it's like a permanent buff. So if you can just spam them loads of times in order to build up things via critical damage rating, oh, that is going to be insanely good. I really cannot wait for this guy's new abilities to hit, and obviously all of these things are subject to change. And finally, the synergies look really impressive. Like, you can't knock them. They're going to be absolutely beneficial for you having your Colossus as being a lead champion, especially considering building a mutant team around this. But, you know, you could have others. You could really bust out that Juggernaut for usage, and at the same time, maybe utilize that unstoppable Colossus, who doesn't get any rework, by the way, for people that have asked. He will be retaining the older Colossus stuff when this new type of abilities come in. There we indeed have it. That has been a video looking at the new teased, spoiler-ish, well, subject to change abilities. Do bear in mind that those were represented on rank 5, 65, 5 stars, and everything could be subject to change. But I'm really impressed with the ideas that have been surrounded by these two. And like I said, probably expect, if they are to make these changes, it is not going to be until September, maybe even October time, which has been reaffirmed by Kabam Zibit in this thread here. But either way, thank you very much for watching this video. Which champion are you more hyped for, Colossus or Old Man Logan? Or are you equally hyped for both? What do you like about the abilities? What don't you? And if you want to check out some more of the abilities and the information we've discussed, then go to the links in the description down below. I've been Rich the Man. Thank you very much for watching. I'll catch you in the next one. Bye-bye for now.